All in-person Pride festivities finally returning to San Francisco, and pretty much everyone right now could use a party and, more importantly, a parade following 2 years of pandemic-related cancellations.
Today in the Bay's Ginger Conejero-Sopp. She's live for us in San Francisco. And Ginger, of course, a lot of Debbie Downers out there pointing out the traffic and congestion. But look, we know that's coming because it is a parade, it is a big celebration, and it's bringing a lot of fun.
It is going to be a lot of fun, as you can imagine, and as you can expect with usual Pride celebrations. There's a lot that's going to be happening, a lot of celebrating going on. Actually, Pride Month has had a lot going on, so things have been happening for a while now, but the official celebration starts tomorrow at 11 and will run through 6, and we'll pick right back up again at midnight and run through 6 p.m. on Sunday. That iconic parade that everybody talks about, that starts Sunday at 10:30. If you take a look at your screens, you'll see the parade route. It starts on Market and Beale Streets and will make its way all the way down to Market and 8th, very similar to Monday's Warriors Championship parade route. Now, a lot of people are expected to come to San Francisco for the weekend, so here are some ways to navigate that. Here's an important piece of advice. Don't drive. BART will be your safest bet. It'll run extra trains from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m., and it will also include special event trains. People from the LGBTQ community that we spoke to say this weekend is really a much-needed boost, both economically and socially. It's been a rough 2 years for bars, clubs, and entertainment venues for the community, especially without Pride Weekend. So they're really counting on this weekend for the uptick in business. We spoke to the owner of Oasis in San Francisco, who says it seems this year there are more events lined up, which is really great for business. But at the same time, that owner also talks about the heightened concern for security amid a recent wave of anti-LGBTQ sentiment.
You know, upsetting and kind of a little nerve-wracking when you're seeing, you know, these people storming the drag queen story hours and libraries and that thing that happened in Idaho. With, I have many friends who have dealt with it, from being chased and attacked. I even had a friend who was shot in the leg.
And that's really unfortunate. They're beefing up security at Oasis throughout the weekend, you know, to address those concerns for security. But at the same time, that owner tells us the celebration, that celebratory mood isn't going to go away. They're going to have a float on the Pride Parade, or at the Pride Parade, for the first time on Sunday. Things aren't going to change, but at the same time, things are definitely going to be aware of more things or more things to look out for.
Right. Well, we know the fun's already getting underway. Ginger, what can people expect today?
Well, Chris, things have been going on all month, but today, I think, is really kind of when things will boost up all throughout the city. There are going to be parties at the different clubs and entertainment venues. We saw that there is a disco night themed party at one of the clubs. There's also a clothing exchange that's going to take place, and we'll take you through that. We'll have more updates from another part of the city over in the Castro District later on.
All right. Thanks, Ginger.